square root of a plus square root of b is equal to 10, square root of ab is equal to 10, we have to find out the value of a and b here. How we can find out? Let's see solution. Square root of a plus square root of b is equal to 10. This is equation number 1. And square root of ab is equal to 10. This is equation number 2. Now, taking first equation, square root of a plus square root of b, right? Whole square, we are taking square of this number, is equal to 10 square. Now, square root of a plus square root of b, this is the a plus b whole square. So, we know the formula, a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. Using this formula here, square root of a whole square plus square root of b whole square plus 2a square. 2ab means 2 square root of a times square root of b is equal to 100. Now this will cancel here. This square is cancelled from this square root. A plus b plus 2 square root of ab, we can write this, is equal to 100. Now a plus b plus 2 square root of ab, that is equal to 10 by equation 2, right? So we can write here 2 times 10 is equal to 100 by equation 2. Now a plus b plus 2 times 10, that is 20, is equal to 100. Now a plus b is equal to 100 minus 20, that is we can write 80. So this is the value of a plus b. A plus b is equal to 80. This is equation number 3. Now square root of ab is equal to 10. This is given, equation number 2. So taking a square here, both sides, we will get a square root of ab whole square is equal to 10 square. This will cancel from here. AB is equal to 100. So we can write here B is equal to 100 by A. This is the value of B. This is equation number 4. A plus B is equal to 80 by equation 3. Now A plus b, b is equal to 100 by a, 100 by a is equal to 80, right? Now we are taking here LCM, so we will get here a, here a square plus 100 is equal to 80. So we can write this, finally we write this a square minus 80 a plus 100 is equal to 0, right? Now a equal to here 1, b is equal to minus 80 and c is equal to 100. Now you can write this a is equal to minus b plus minus b square minus 4ac upon 2a is equal to minus b, that is minus 80, right? Because value of b, that is minus 80, plus minus b square minus 80 square minus 4 times a 1 times c, that is 100, divided by 2 times 1 is equal to minus minus plus 80 plus minus 8, it's a 64, so it will become 6400 minus 400 divided by 2 is equal to, we can write this 80 plus minus 6400 minus 400, that is 6000 divided by 2 is equal to, we can write this 80 plus minus 4 times 1500 divided by 2 is equal to 80 plus minus square root of 4, that is 2. 2 times square root of 1500 divided by 2. Now is equal to 2 4 ja 8. 40 plus minus 2, this cancel, 1500, right, is equal to, so we can write 40 plus minus this 1500, we can write 100 times 15, right, we can write this one, that is 1500. Now is equal to 14 plus minus this 100, square root of 100, that is 10, times square root of 15. So we can write here value of A is equal to 40 plus 10 square root of 15, or A equal to 40 minus 10 square root of 15. So this is the value of A. First one 40 plus 10 square root of 15, and second one 40 minus 10 square root of 15. Now we have to find out the value of B. B equal to, so we know that A plus B is equal to 80 given. Therefore, we can write B is equal to 80 minus A is equal to 80 minus A. Value of A in first case, this is case 1, 80 minus A, that is 40 plus 10 square root of 15 is equal to 80 minus 40 minus plus minus 10 square root of 15 is equal to 80 minus 40, 40 minus 10 square root of 15. This is the value of B in first case. And in next term, that is A equal to, if A is equal to 40 minus 10 square root of 15, at that time we will get here. This is case 2, A plus B is equal to 80, then B is equal to 80 minus A. B is equal to 80 minus A. Value of A, that is 40 minus 10 square root of 15. This is the value of A in second case. So 80 minus 40 plus minus minus plus 10 square root of 15 is equal to 80 minus 40, 40 plus 10 square root of 15. This is the value of B in case 2. So we got here two value of A and B. First one is A1 B1 is equal to, when A1 is 40 plus 10 square root of 15, at that time B1 is 40 minus 10 square root of 15. And in second term, A2 and B2 is equal to 40 minus 10 square root of 15. At that time, B2 is equal to 40 plus 10 square root of 15. So this is the solution A and B. Thank you.